So today we start the new chapter, that is
inverse trigonometric functions. Inverse trigonometric functions. And the related topic is, there is one mark question, two mark question, and one 3 mark question, that is 3 plus 4, that is 8 marks. For your exam, the weightage of this chapter is 8 marks. So there is one mark question and two mark question, and there is one 3 mark question. The total weightage is 8 marks. So before we are going to start this chapter, so first we will understand. So what is the meaning of inverse trigonometric functions? So another study. So that is trigonometric functions in first year, right? So what is inverse trigonometric functions here? So what is inverse trigonometric functions? We have 6 trigonometric functions: sin x, cos x, tan x, cosec x, sec x, and cot x. So these are 6 trigonometric functions already studied in first year. So what are the inverse trigonometric functions? So that is sin inverse of x, cos inverse of x, tan inverse of x, cosec inverse of x, and sec inverse of x, and cot inverse of x. So these are inverse trigonometric functions. So sin x, cos x, tan x, cosec, sec, and cot, these are trigonometric functions, and these are inverse trigonometric functions. Next, see. So how we get this inverse trigonometric functions? How we get this inverse trigonometric functions? See. So what is sine of 30 degrees? See. What is sine of 30 degrees? Already we know it is 1 by 2. If you take sine here, so that will become sine inverse. Right? So sine of 30 degrees is 1 by 2. If you take sine on the right hand side, so that will become sine inverse of 1 by 2. So that is equal to how much this will come here, that is 30 degrees. For example, see here. If sine x is equal to y, so then what is x? X is equal to take sine here, then x will become sine inverse of y. Here sine x is a trigonometric function. Here sine inverse y is a inverse trigonometric function. See, sine 30 is 1 by 2. So then sine inverse of 1 by 2, so that is 30 degrees. Similarly, we can see tan of 45 degrees. So tan of 45 degrees is 1. If you take tan on the right hand side, so that is tan inverse of 1. So that is equal to how much it is? 45 degrees. This is trigonometric function. This is inverse trigonometric function. Similarly, cos of 30 degrees is equal to how much it is? Root 3 by 2. So then what is 30 degrees? 30 degrees, take cos here. So that will become cos inverse of root 3 by 2. So therefore, how we can pronounce it? See. So sin 30 degrees is 1 by 2. Sin inverse of 1 by 2 is 30 degrees. So sin of each angle is 1 by 2 is 30 degrees. Similarly, tan of 45 is 1. Now take tan on right hand side. Tan inverse of 1 means tan of which angle is 1? So that is 45 degrees. Therefore, tan 45, sin 30, cos 30, they are trigonometric function. And sin inverse of 1 by 2, tan inverse of 1, or cos inverse of root 3 by 2. So they are called as inverse trigonometric function. So here we can observe, so in trigonometric function, sin of some angle is a real value. Is it clear? So this is trigonometric function. What is the major difference between trigonometry and inverse trigonometric function? We can observe here. Inside sine we have 30 degrees, inside tan we have 45 degrees, inside cos we have 30 degrees. For trigonometric function, they all are angles. So sine of some angle or cos of some angle, tan of some angle, cosec of some angle. So it is always a real value. Right? So in inverse trigonometric function, see it. In inverse trigonometric function, so when we have sin inverse or cos inverse or tan inverse, always here we have, see, tan inverse, or it can be cosec inverse, or it can be sec inverse, or it can be cot inverse, always inside we have, we can observe tan inverse of 1, sin inverse of 1 by 2, cos inverse of root 3 by 2. Inside we have real value. What is the answer for inverse trigonometric function? The answer is always an angle. You can observe here. So for trigonometric function, inside we have angle. So sin of some angle, cos of some angle, so tan of some angle, so inside. So for trigonometric function, always we have an angle. So the answer is always a real value. But for inverse trigonometric function, sine inverse, cos inverse, sec inverse, cosec inverse, sec inverse, and tan inverse. So when we have inverse trigonometric function, we must have real value. So this is here what I mean to say. When you write sine inverse of 60 degrees, so this is wrong. Why wrong? When we write inverse trigonometric function, inside must be a real value, not an angle. So when it is sine inverse, cos inverse, tan inverse, sec inverse, inside must be a real value like 1 by 2, root 3 by 2, 1 by root 2, like that. So inside we must have real value when it is an inverse trigonometric function. But when it is trigonometric, this is also wrong. Sine of root 3 by 2. So this is also wrong. Because when you write a sine, cos, tan, if you write also, it will consider it as a some radial angle. Right? So, but sine of root 3 by 2, this is wrong. When we write sine, cos, tan, so this must be angle. Right? So when it is inverse trigonometric function, this must be real value. When it is trigonometric function, this must be an angle. Right? So therefore, inverse trigonometric function, see. So see, I will write something down. See, students, next. So how we have to pronounce this here? Sine inverse of 1, okay. Tan inverse of 1 by root 3, cos inverse of 1, sec inverse of root 2, or tan inverse of root 3, similarly, sine inverse of 1 by root 2. Let us, so these all are inverse trigonometric functions. Sine inverse of 1 means sine of which angle is 1. So that is 90 degree or 5 by 2 is answer. Right? Sine inverse of 1 means sine of which angle is 1. So the answer is 90 degree or 5 by 2. So tan inverse of 1 by root 3. Tan of which angle is 1 by root 3? So that is 30 degree. Tan of which angle is 1 by root 3? That is 30 degree is answer. So cos inverse of 1. Cos of which angle is 1? Cos of which angle is 1? That is 0 degree. Similarly, sec inverse of root 2. Sec of which angle is root 2? Sec of which angle is root 2, that is 5 by 4. Similarly, cot inverse of root 3. Cot of which angle is root 3? Cot of which angle is root 3, that is 30 degree on 5 by 6. 5 by 4, or it is 45 degree. Sin of which angle is 1 by root 2? Sin of which angle is 1 by root 2, that is 45 degree or 5 by 4. Right, so these all are inverse trigonometric functions. But students, here we have some ambiguity or there is some confusion. What is that confusion see here? So let us see, sine inverse of 1 by 2, we have many answers. For example, see, sine of which angle is 1 by 2, sine of 30 is also 1 by 2. Similarly, sine inverse of 1 by 2, sine of 150 is also 1 by 2. We can see, what is sine 150 degree? Sine of 150 degree is in second quadrant. So when we have angle in second quadrant, this 150, we can write it as sine of 180 minus theta. So what is sine of 180 minus theta? In second quadrant, sine will be positive. Sine of 180 degree minus theta. In second quadrant, sine will be positive. That is sine theta. That is sine 30 degree. What is sine 30 degrees? Again, we have 1 by 2. Similarly, sine inverse of 1 by 2. So sine inverse of 1 by 2 can be, so that is 390 degree. Because sine of 390 is also 1 by 2. Similarly, sine inverse of 1 by 2 is also 750 degrees. Right, so sine inverse of 1 by 2 is also 1110, that is 1110 degrees. And we have many answers. We have many answers. Right, so we have infinite solutions for a given value. If we have infinite solution, so that function is not invertible. Right, so if you have sine inverse, that function must be 1 and not 2. If you want to restrict this answer, so that is sine inverse of 1 by 2 should have only one answer. Because we have to make it 1 and not 2, already we have discussed in relations and function. If a function should have inverse, that function should be 1 and not 2. So that is sine inverse of 1 by 2, if this value has to exist, it must have only one value. So we have many values here. To restrict this, so they have defined the range and domain of inverse trigonometry. So, to make sin inverse of 1 by 2 only one value, or to get only one answer for sin inverse of 1 by 2, to make a sin inverse 1 and not 2, you have defined the range and domain of inverse trigonometric functions. Now we will see range and domain of inverse trigonometric function. See student. Now we will see range and domain of inverse trigonometric function. So what is the meaning of range and domain? Already we know in first year relations and functions. What is the range and domain of inverse trigonometric function? Right? See, so what is the range and domain? Right? So this is important. So there will be one mark questions based on this range and domain table. Right? So and again, it is very important for CET also. Everybody should remember this range and domain table. Right? So first one, see. So first I will write. So sine inverse, cos inverse, right? So cosec inverse, sec inverse, tan inverse, and cot inverse. So we have six trigonometric function. First I will type. So domain range. So in sine inverse x, the possible values of x is called as domain, and possible values of sine inverse x is called as range. Already we know, right? So first we will see. So what is the domain of? Everybody should remember this table. What is the domain of sine inverse? So it can take values from minus 1 to plus 1. That is, sine inverse inside, we can write any value. Here we can write any value which is in between minus 1 and plus 1. Suppose sine inverse of 2, this is not defined because 2 is not in the domain of sine inverse. Sine inverse inside value, we can write anything in between minus 1 and plus 1. If the value that lies outside minus 1 and plus 1, then that function is not defined. Because sine inverse of 2 does not exist, because what is the maximum value of sine is 1. Right? So therefore, the domain of sine inverse is minus 1 to 1, and range of sine inverse is minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2. Right? So then cos inverse, its domain is also minus 1 to 1, and its range is 0 to pi. Right? So now see it. So sine inverse of 1 by 2, already we got many answers, 30 degree, 150 degree, 390 degree, 750 degree. Which is correct answer? We have to choose the answer which lies between minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2. That means minus 90 to plus 90. So in this case, we have many answers for sine inverse of 1 by 2. But we have to choose the answer which lies between minus 90 to plus 90. So both these. So which lies between minus 90 to plus 90, that is 30 degree. So therefore 30 degree is the correct answer. Is it clear, students? So next is here, the range of cos inverse. Similarly, cos inverse of 1 by root 2, so 45 degree is also correct, 350 degree is also correct, 405 degree. We have many answers or we have many solutions for cos inverse of 1 by root 2. So but which is the correct answer? Tell me answer which lies between 0 to pi. 0 to pi means what? 0 to 180. So the answer which lies between 0 to 180 degree is correct answer. Out of this, which answer lies between 0 to 180 degree? That is 45 degree. So therefore, 45 degree is the only correct answer for cos inverse of 1 by 2. This is how we restrict the solutions of inverse trigonometry function to one value by defining the range and domain. Right? So now see. So cosec inverse, we can take all real values except minus 1 and plus 1, except the values between minus 1 and plus 1, its range is, so now it is minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2, except 0 because cosec 0 is not defined. Minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2, except 0. Why 0 is not included? Because cosec 0 is infinity. The function is 1, 1 and not 2, it should be defined for all the values of x, right? So the range is minus pi by 2 plus pi by 2 except 0 because cosec 0 is infinity. Right? Similarly, sec inverse can have all real value except the value between minus 1 and plus 1. So its range is 0 to pi except pi by 2 because sec pi by 2 is not defined. So the range is 0 to pi except pi by 2 because sec 90 is not defined. Similarly, tan inverse you can take all real values. So tan inverse you can take all real values as a domain, and what it is range, you can take minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2, that is open bracket. So for sine inverse it is closed bracket. What is the meaning of this closed bracket? When x belongs to minus 5 by 2 plus 5 by 2. What is the meaning? This x can take all the values in between minus 5 by 2 plus 5 by 2, including minus 92 plus 90. So when it is a closed bracket, minus 98 plus 90 is included because sine of 90 is defined. So for tan inverse, here x belongs to minus 5 by 2 to plus 5 by 2. So that is closed bracket, that is open bracket. What is the meaning of open bracket? X can take all the values from minus 5 by 2 to plus 5 by 2. So minus 98 plus 90 is not included. So it can take all the values between minus 90 to plus 90. So that is from minus 89, minus 88, minus 87 to plus 89. 90 is not included because tan 90 is not defined, that is tan 90 is infinity. So therefore, the range of tan inverse is minus 5 by 2 to plus 5 by 2, right? So that is open bracket. So since why tan inverse is closed bracket, sin 90 is defined. Why tan inverse is open bracket, tan 90 is not defined, right? So similarly cot inverse, so its domain is also all real numbers. So except what is the range? Range of cot inverse is open bracket 0 to pi. Here also pi it is open bracket. So cot 0 is also not defined. Cot pi is also not defined. But cot inverse is defined for all values in between 0 to pi. That is 1 degree, 2 degree, 3 degree, so on up to 179. Cot pi, that is cot 180 is not defined. That is cot 180 is infinity. Right? So but here cos inverse is 0 to pi. That is closed bracket. Since cos 0 is also defined, and cos pi is also defined, it is a closed bracket. So this is closed bracket where these two values are included. This is the open bracket where these two values are excluded, and you have to take all the values between 0 to pi. So this is a range and domain table. This is very important. In exam they may ask one question like this. What is the range of sine inverse? The range of sine inverse is, just you have to write this, minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2. What is the domain of cos inverse? What is the domain of cos inverse? Minus 1 to 1. What is the range of tan inverse? Range of tan inverse is minus 5 by 2 to plus 5. What is the domain of sec inverse? Domain of sec inverse is all real numbers except minus 1 to 1. Right? So what is the range of cot inverse? What is the range of cot inverse? 0 to pi. Then you ask one more question on this range and domain table. And this table you everybody should remember because these values you are going to use in problems. Right? So this is the range and domain. Now we understood why this range and domain is defined for a given inverse trigonometric function. Without this range and domain, that function is not invertible because for a given value like sine inverse of 1 by 2, we have many answers like 30 degree, 150 degree. To restrict that answer to a single value or to make a function 1 and 2, they have defined this range and domain. Right? So based on range and domain only, we are writing only one answer which lies between the given value. Right? So you should remember this range and domain table, and there will be one more question on range and domain table in the final exam. Is it clear, friends? So in the next class, we have some properties of inverse trigonometric function. So that properties we will see in the next class. Okay?